I'm Phil Stoker and I play second horn in the BBC Philharmonic. I first became interested in music as a child. I was sort of a musical family. My mum and dad liked music, but there's no one actually doing any performing or playing. So I, at school I learned guitar for a couple of years, and I changed school and asked for guitar lessons, but I haven't got any guitar lessons, but we can do brass lessons. So I switched to a brass instrument and played the horn then, really, from the age of 10. I went on a music summer course, which is like a week's residential, kind of learning some harder stuff with a bigger catch, but a pool of players. And the guy who was teaching specifically the horn on that course, he was played in the Northern Sinfonia based in Newcastle. And I asked him whether I could have lessons with him. And that was really the start of taking it much more seriously, really. It was him who encouraged me to apply for music college when he reached that stage in sixth form. In my fourth year at the RNCM, it's a four-year course, I was applying for jobs that were coming up, and jobs are generally few and far between, so you've got to make the most of the ones that come up. One came up in Wales, in the BBC National Orchestra of Wales. I applied for the job, had to go down to Wales to do an audition, and there was a panel of five or six people, mostly the horn section and someone from the orchestra management, and they were quite positive and helpful during the audition, asked some nice questions and came across reasonably nice bunch. So when I got home, I got a phone call a few days later asking me whether I'd go down and do a trial with them. And I was delighted, I was surprised, but delighted. Well, the trial process for orchestral jobs, you say there might be 80 or 90 people applied for the job, and they would generally hear as many of those as they looked good on the CV, and they'll do a short list of about six or eight players, and each of those players has to come in and do like two or three periods of trial, and the idea is just to narrow down the field before a decision is made and someone's appointed. So I was in the BBC Welsh for 6 years, and a job came up in Manchester in the BBC Philharmonic. I knew the players very well and I had a lot of respect for the band, and so I applied for the job here and had to go through the whole process again, the audition process, the shortlist, the kind of the narrowing down, and eventually after 8 months perhaps from start of the application through to getting the job again. My big tip for an auditionee is to be as prepared as possible, and that involves learning the excerpts that we send them. These days you generally get sent a wadge of music that we'd like to hear, just to hear what they can do with orchestral things. We get given a set piece, and there's no excuse not to be able to play all of that really well. So to be as well prepared as you can, know how these excerpts fit into the pieces they come from, so you've got an idea of the dynamics, the speed, the all that kind of thing, the interpretation, so that they played in a manner that you would recognise. Just have a really good idea of what you want to do with your instrument, or how you want to express yourself, so it's kind of finding something within yourself that you feel you can express in the music that you make. And that sort of works at a deeper level. You may be able to learn the instrument and to go through the process of playing the notes, but it needs to go beyond that and to a deeper level. It's just expressing something that's inside, or expressing what the composer may have written, and it's a very important thing to be able to communicate that, I suppose, through the music that you do. I think the orchestra itself has a personality which comes across. There's times it's so good you have to sort of pinch yourself to think I'm actually being paid to do this, sitting in an orchestra. So it's something that I love doing.